The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, announced that Parliament will only foot the medical bills of Segirinya once his documents are in order with the Uganda Medical Board. The MP is currently admitted to the Amsterdam UMC Hospital in the Netherlands.
If you have any ailment that requires treatment abroad, you have to apply to the Uganda Medical Board for referral. I have cross-checked. The medical board has not received any application from the Honorable Segirinya. But also the office of the speaker and office of the clerk has not received any formal information from the Honorable Segirinya about his treatment. Let's now be proactive and see how best we can help him.
MPs, led by the leader of opposition, complained on the poor quality of services rendered by insurance companies which were contracted by Parliament to treat MPs. It was noted that these health insurance covers can only offer Panadol to sick MPs.
Revise our insurance scheme. It's not very helpful to so many members, and they're complaining. Some of the insurance companies, I think, are cheating members. Some of them are supplying air.
I already instructed the clerk to study this matter and prepare a commission paper, which is going to be handled at the next meeting of the Parliamentary Commission.
This week has also seen Parliament finally passing the Narcotic and Psychotropic Substances Control Bill 2023, which outlawed cultivation of cat without a license. Offenders face a fine of 2.4 million shillings, equivalent to 120 currency points, or triple the market value. The law goes on to tighten restrictions for cultivation of cannabis for medical use and sets harsh penalties for a multitude of offenses related to substance abuse.
Speaker and honorable members, I beg to move that the bill entitled the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Control Substances Bill be read for the third time and do pass into law.
I put the question that the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substance Control Bill 2023 be read the third time and do pass. Those in favor say aye, to the contrary nay.
Parliament this week approved government to borrow $608.66 million from the World Bank and French Development Agency to construct 611 kilometers of roads in the Kampala metropolitan area in the move to address traffic congestion and dilapidated road infrastructure. This was after the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, assured the House that the loan is not affected by the recent World Bank pronouncement to stop funding of new projects in Uganda due to the enactment of the anti-homosexuality law.
Confirmation from you as a minister that indeed this is not one of the affected.
The assurance I want to give this House is that the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area project is not among the projects affected by the World Bank statement. It is therefore proper that we consider the project and process it.
Still about loans, Parliament also approved proposal by government to borrow 147.69 million euros from the African Development Fund and 65 million euros from the African Development Bank and 25.98 million euros from the Corporate Internationalization Fund of Spain for the refurbishment of the Kampala-Malaba meter gauge railway project.
That in a single day we have thousands of trucks plying that same route, causing many accidents. This would be a game changer for our economy.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.